iOS 18 is here, but what's new in iOS 18? What are new cool features in iOS 18? Let's dive in and see what's new in iOS 18 beta. Hey guys, I'm Abhishek from TechReview Pro and welcome back to another video about iOS 18 new changes and features. So friends, the first new iOS 18 feature is related to personalization of the home screen layout. Earlier, when you move or place apps on the home screen, they used to be placed and aligned next to the previous app and with a fixed positioning. But now, with iOS 18, you can easily move and place any app anywhere as per your preferences with proper spacing like this. The second iOS 18 feature is related to the iOS app's color change. Yes, now with iOS 18, you can easily customize and change your app icon color, tint, etc. on your iPhone. If you just tap and hold on your home screen, the app will start jiggling. And after that, if you tap on edit and then select customize, your iPhone will allow you to change the color and size of any application. For example, you may tap on dark to change the iPhone app color to darker icons. You may also tap and choose the tinted option, and there you get various color change options. You may choose any color and change the tint of the apps on iOS 18 like this. The third iOS 18 new cool feature is also related to the personalization and customizations of apps. Earlier, you could only change and set dark mode system wide and that too for wallpapers only. But now with iOS 18, you can easily change the iOS app icon color and get a dark mode for app icon colors on your iPhone. And the new dark mode for app icons on iOS 18 looks pretty cool in my opinion. Alright, the next iOS 18 new feature and something which I think is the most useful iOS 18 feature is about locking apps on iPhone. Yes, the iOS feature with the ability to hide and lock apps on iPhone was much awaited, and thankfully, it's here, finally introduced in iOS 18. Now, you can lock and hide any app in iOS 18 on your iPhone. For example, if you want to lock the Photos app on the iPhone so that our private pictures are hidden, then we will simply tap and hold the Photos app icon. And when you do that, you will get these various options, in which you also get this option that says require face ID. Simply tap on that and then tap again to confirm that you want to lock this app on iPhone with a face ID. Now, if anyone tries to open the Photos app on your iPhone will ask for a face ID. And if the face ID doesn't match, iOS won't authorize opening the app for them, thus allowing only you to open the app with a matching face ID. Similarly, you may lock any app with face ID on your iPhone. The next iOS 18 new feature is about hiding the apps on your iPhone. Yes friends, now you can hide any app on your iPhone with iOS 18. Earlier, when you tap and hold any app from the home screen, you only got the option to remove it from the home screen or delete the app. And since the app removed from the home screen could have been easily found from the app library, you had no other way to hide iPhone apps completely without permanently deleting the app from your iPhone. But now with iOS 18, if you pay close attention here, you can see that there is a new folder in the app library with the name hidden. This is basically the folder for hidden apps, and if you tap on it, it will scan your face, and if it matches with face ID, only then it will show you the apps inside the hidden folder. To hide any app on your iPhone, you simply need to tap and hold the app you want to hide on iOS 18, and from these various options, tap and select required face ID. When you tap on that, it will ask for the confirmation, just like you have the required face ID option to lock apps with the face ID. Similarly, you also get this hide and require face ID option. And when you tap on hide and require face ID, this will hide any app and move it to a hidden app folder so that you may access it by unhiding the app with a face ID lock mechanism. As you can see, you don't see any app here in the hidden folder currently. But if you scan and unlock with a face ID, the hidden app will unhide and start showing again. The next awesome feature of iOS 18 is related to revamped control center. I guess this is the third ever change in the control center design in the history of iOS. And I must say, this is the best ever iOS control center. If you expose the control center on your iPhone, you will see a new design of the control center like this. As you may have noticed here, with the new control center on iOS 18, you get the scrolling control center like this. And as you can see, multiple pages in the control center simply allow you to categorize your control center icons on different pages. You also get the option to add new pages and change icons in the control center as per your preferences. And that brings us to our next iOS 18 feature and change, which is also related to the control center. If you just expose the new control center on iOS 18, you get this plus icon in the top left. And if you tap on that and then tap on the option that says add a control, you will see the various control icons here with a search controls bar on the top. From here, you may choose and select any control icon to add to the control center and customize your control center pages on the iPhone. Okay, the next iOS 18 feature and change is also related to the control center on iPhone. But this is about the controls you get on the lock screen of your iPhone. As you can see here, on the earlier version of iOS, you used to see only two controls, the camera icon and the flashlight icon. And both of them were by default. You could do nothing about them. But now with iOS 18, you get the option to change these lock screen controls and set any other control options to replace these control options on the lock screen. To change and replace them, simply tap and hold on the lock screen the same way you used to customize your wallpaper earlier. And then tap on customize. Then you will see the flashlight and camera icons in a circle with a minus sign next to each icon circle. Simply tap on the minus sign to remove existing controls and then tap on the plus icon to select any other app control icon that you want to replace it with. The next iOS 18 settings and change is related to messaging. If you go to the message app and open any messaging thread, here you will see that the tap back option, which used to have very limited options earlier, has now changed and it has got various colorful emojis. New options and also the ability to add your own custom stickers. You may react easily to messages with any of the stickers of your favorite emojis. To react, you simply need to tap here and you will see all the emojis including the stickers if you have created any stickers previously. The next iOS 18 feature is also related to messages. So if you just type any message and try sending it to anyone, for example, if I type good morning here, after typing, you will see an option here for text customization. You may tap on that and add customization to the text in your message, like you may make the text bold, italic and underline, or add a strike through as well. There are other options as well. You may use them to add animation and special effects to the text and animate your text messages in the recipient's inbox. Alright, moving on the next iOS 18 feature and change, which is also related to messaging. Now you may easily schedule text messages in iMessage on your iPhone running on iOS 18 or later. To schedule any text message and send it later in iMessage, you just need to tap on this plus icon. And from these various options, select the send later option. Now tap on this and change the schedule time to which you want to send the text message. Once you set the time, type the message you want to send and then tap on the send button. This will schedule your text message to be sent later, and iMessage will automatically send this message later on and deliver on that specific time and day. Alright, the next iOS 18 new feature is related to the mail app on your iPhone. Yes, now the mail app on iOS 18 has got the categorization option, and you may categorize emails based upon categories in the mail app on your iPhone just like Gmail. But this feature is not available right now. Apple has mentioned that this mail app feature will be available later this year, maybe with iPhone 16. Who knows? The next big change in iOS 18 is the introduction of a dedicated password manager app. Earlier, you had a keychain option in settings, which was used to save your passwords and sync them across all your Apple devices using iCloud. But now, with iOS 18, you get a dedicated password manager app named Passwords. And this app will save and manage all your passwords, not just website and app passwords, but also Wi-Fi passwords, authentication keys, and other password security options that you may manage from one place. What's more important is that you also get a dedicated place to manage your shared password with the family group. The next iOS 18 new feature is related to the phone app, and it's something that I like the most. If you dial any number, your iPhone will now fetch your contacts and show all the related saved numbers and contacts. Yes, now on iOS 18, your iPhone gets T9 dialing, allowing you to quickly dial phone numbers from the contacts by typing in letters on the numeric keypad. So friends, these are the top 10 new iOS 18 features and changes in the iOS 18 beta. I hope you like this video. If you want to see a detailed overview of all the iOS 18 new features, changes and tricks, make sure you subscribe to the channel and tap on the bell icon, because I will be following up with more such videos related to iOS 18.